So Nikhil, I'm going to put you on the spot first. So for the new age investor who's basically looking for opportunities other than mutual fund and FDs and other vanilla options, what do new age investments actually mean? Can you like explain what they mean?
Sure. I think it's sort of an ambiguous answer. Most people think of investments to being only the two things that you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
And the predominant reason is that the ticket size for investment has limited people from exploring new products or new avenues. If you look at the panel today, none of us are, it's not like you've created something out of the blue or, you know, out of thin air. These are all products that have existed for centuries. Leasing, for example, was one of the earliest forms of providing capital and business growth for companies. The reason we call them new age is because as a factor of technology and because of the way they're being provided to users, especially a new type of users, they are becoming available. P2P lending, you know, companies like what Ikmeet is doing, invoice discounting, what Abhishek is doing, fractional ownership of commercial real estate, inventory financing and lease financing, which Grip is doing, I think are some of those examples for the new age products that we're seeing today. I am sure that there will be more in the future and some of us will innovate in that space, but we are at the tip of that diversification and adding new investment options for individual investors.
I was just about to say tip of the iceberg, right? There's so much to explore.
Just to add on to what Nikhil mentioned, guys, sorry to interrupt here. What all three, all four of us are trying to do in our own respective ways is we pick up an asset, we pick up a quality asset, we break that down into smaller fractions, and then take it out to retail audience, which previously would not have been able to access that majorly because of the capital intensive nature of such kind of assets. Mm-hmm. Or maybe the kind of time commitment that people need to invest into in order to gain a certain value out of such assets. And essentially what all three of us, all four of us in fact, are trying to do is doing something similar, but the asset that underlies all four platforms is different.
Yeah.
I am more than 100% sure that there is a huge overlap in the kind of investors that all of us focus on. Yeah. But yes, essentially it is providing a different kind of asset with different kind of quality to each of our investors. I think what Nikhil rightly mentioned that these new age investment options are nothing new. They are these same principles have been applied in the offline world. A lot of seasoned investors are doing this, have been doing this. Our uncles, our parents have been doing this in the offline world. More so in a more unorganized manner. But what all of us have been able to successfully do is create an organized sector around it and take it to a level that even somebody with as small as 50,000 rupees of investment surplus can also invest into asset like these.
Wow.
Sorry, Sudarshan, not talking on your behalf. Where the
I think it's all about being accessible to the retail investor. You're trying to get these investment opportunities out there.